This is part four of a read of a very, very important article that was posted by Dame Wigington of geoengineeringwatch.org. Former Air Force officer warns of atmospheric spraying and the coming collapse. If you have missed part one, part two, and part three, go to my channel and you can listen to this article. But I start part four right here. A major concern is that Obama, prior to the November elections, will declare a state of martial law on some fabricated pretext or false flag terrorist event, unless he can incite enough Americans to clash over racial, religious, or other differences. Yes, we are being socially engineered to hate one another, to argue with one another, whether it's based on religion or race. Please don't be manipulated by mainstream media. But Operation Jade Helm 15, which ran from July 15 to September 15, 2015, was not, as we were told, a military exercise. Remember, this article was written by an Air Force colonel. It was not a military exercise. It provided an opportunity to redistribute military vehicles and ordnance across the country, as well as to equip law enforcement agencies with excess military gear, weapons, ammunition, protective vests, armored personnel carriers, and in some cases, tanks. Perhaps you have seen one of the 2 to 3 mile long freight trains consisting solely of 80-foot flat cars fully loaded with APCs, armored personnel carriers, tanks, NRAPs, mine-resistant ambush-protected vehicles, and even field artillery pieces. I cannot stress strongly enough the importance of thinking, planning, preparing, and behaving more aggressively, but still peacefully, in each of your own communities, as opposed to writing to your elected representatives. Someone once said the most dangerous item in your home is your recliner, to which I would add your computer. Your thoughts, opinions, and concerns are irrelevant to them. Their safety and that of their families has been provided for underground. If you do not know your neighbors, make it a point to get to know them. For as long as they will work, create phone call lists. A principal use of a call list is not only emergency communication, but the transfer of intel or intelligence on such things as the movements of enemy forces, the influx of armored vehicles. In other words, this colonel is telling you to think like you're in the military. Think like soldiers. And soldiers protect one another. That's why it's so important for families to come together, for communities to come together. There is a reason why families and communities have been deliberately broken by the social engineers who are psychopaths. But your thoughts, opinions, and concerns are irrelevant to your politicians. Their safety, their families, they've been provided for. So if you do not know your neighbors, make it a point to get to know them. For as long as they will work, create phone call lists. I know that I'm repeating this, but it's very important information. A principal use of a call list is not only emergency communication, but the transfer of intel or intelligence on such things as the movements of enemy forces, the influx of armored vehicles, etc. As a longtime friend, an active duty Lieutenant Colonel told me recently, I cannot say much, but I will tell you that the fuse is very short. At this writing, my understanding from an active duty senior NCO is that Chinook, many of them black and unmarked, therefore FEMA helicopters, C-130s, Boeing 727, 737, and 747 fixed-wing aircraft are being fitted with wide-range radio jamming equipment. The purpose is to neutralize civilian, cellular, survivalist, or militia communications. Initially, Chinooks will be used to transport detained American citizens to nearby FEMA camps. If a detainee is to be held at a more distant FEMA camp location, he or she will be transported by one of the aforementioned aircraft. The senior NCO with whom I spoke to did not know whether these jamming devices were being installed on other military vehicles, ships, or base locations, however, given that the president has the authority to control the airwaves, all of them, it seems likely that taking away the ability for us to communicate would answer that question. Until we learn otherwise, we have several communicative options currently at our disposal. Many of you remember the days when CB, Citizens Band radios, were popular, and some of you may still own one. Well, they are popular again. If you own one, you may wish to consider dusting it off, installing an antenna, preferably outdoor, and providing it with a 12-volt DC power from a power supply, a boat or car battery, or your solar power system. Channel 3 has been designated as the national CB emergency frequency. If your radio has single sideband capability, channel 36 LSB, lower sideband, is also available as an emergency frequency. Single sideband signals use a narrower slice of the radio spectrum, travel greater distances than other modes of communication, and are slightly less affected by man-made or naturally occurring noise. In recent years, a relatively new radio service, and again, Snagit's given my warning, but in recent years, a relatively new radio service which uses handheld low-power radios has become very popular among campers, boaters, hunters, and others. And I'm going to stop here, and yes, I am posting part 5 as soon as I am done.